Watching TV, Ernest Tubb was singing loud. I said, he's the man for me, I love him, there's no doubt. I'm leaving you and going now to find out where he's at. And if I can't find him, I'll settle for that bluegrass luster flat.
Memphis and Nashville are 200 miles apart in a straight line. And they're at opposite ends of the universe, musically.
Long distance information, give me Memphis, Tennessee. Find the party, trying to get in touch with me. She could not leave her number, but I know who placed the call, 'cause my uncle took the message.
It was Beale Street and the blues that made Memphis.
He don't miss my girl.
You see, the music from the Delta is, to me, is the foundation of all of it.
Black gospel and the blues gravitated to the city of Memphis and then moved North Chicago. But whatever we had that was white country shifted to Nashville.
Don't you think maybe we could find us a brand new restaurant here?
Like one would say, well, let's don't go there and record because they don't know nothing about country music. It's all rhythm and blues. And then they would say the same thing and in Memphis, let's don't go to Nashville because they don't know anything about rhythm and blues. Just they just old, that old country. But now today, we're kind of looking at each other and liking each other's things because we're so close.
About half past dead. I just need some place where I can lay my head. Hey, mister, can you tell me where a man might find a bed? He just grinned, shook my hand, and know was all he said.
Take a load off Fanny. Take a load for free. Take a load.
My bags, went looking for a place to hide. When I saw old Carmen and the devil walking side by side, I said, hey Carmen, come on, let's go downtown. She said, I gotta go, but my friend can stick around.
What I would like to see happen ultimately with this record is that somehow without dotting the I and putting the token pedal steel guitar in there, so, well, that's country, and geez, those Kunga drums are R&B. I would like it, I'd like it to be seamless. I'd like to stay true to the song.
Go down, Moses. There's nothing that you can say.
Robot Pop Staples goes back to the days of the Delta Blues. He knew and worked with people like Charlie Patton, Robert Johnson, Robert Jr. Lockwood, and many others.
So I started playing when I was a boy. Played down there, played a few blues in Mississippi. When we get through picking cotton, we sat out on the big porch and sang.
Take a load for free. Take a load off Fanny.
And you put the load right on, right on me.
Marty Stewart is probably the purest of the current traditional country performers, and he has always maintained that type of straight country, rural mountain music approach.
Pops and I are both from Mississippi, so we got to work this thing out together. But we probably had some of the same influences, you know, in our formative days musically. And we were all raised in the church house, and I think I hear all kind of influences in the way that musically I hear a bit of gospel in this, you know.
God made man and he made him out of clay. Put him on earth, but not to stay.
Pharaoh's army got found dead. All made of wheat.
Well, I think the Mississippi Delta was just as fertile to American culture as the Delta was in ancient Egypt. It was where black people heard the white man's music and made something new out of it. It was where the white man heard the black man's music. And, you know, people say the blues came from Africa. Well, I think they really came from the deep south.
Man, I thank God that they invented guitars to get people like you and me out of cotton fields. We've just been in the way down there, man.
Take a load off, man. Take a load.
I always felt that country music was just white soul music, and that essentially thematically you're dealing with the same material, and even musically you're on this chord that's based pretty much from, you know, comes from the blues, really.
Rhythm and blues was one of the hybrid forms that emerged out of the jazz revolution of the mid and late 40s, when people like Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, and many others began making harmonic and melodic changes in the music. Some of the other musicians who had gotten their apprenticeship in swing bands, rather than adapt and change to the bebop form, they took what they'd always done, the swing and the jump, and they simply merged swing and jump with gospel-based vocals, and that's really where rhythm and blues comes from.
I get two kicks on Route 66. I go through St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, and Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty, you see.
Since I fell for you, oh yeah, yeah.
Since I fell for you, great song, man. Now, you call, see, that's the difference. We call them, the black folk call them torches. White folk call them pop. Always that difference in there.
I had no trouble getting into this at all. I thought I would because, like I said, the song has been done 9,000 times by, you know, by everybody. There's just a big difference in the way that music sounded and the way the music sounds today. There was something about the melodies. There was something about the words that made it all just work, and you never forgot those melodies.
Depart. That it's so, and yet I know I can't get you out of my heart. You made me leave my happy home. You took my love, and now you're gone, 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 gone. Since I fell for you. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, love.
Sang with me.
Bring such misery and pain. I guess I'll never, I guess I'll never be the same. Since I fell for you,
I gotta say this right here. Well, well, it's too bad.
Oh, it's too bad.
Oh, and it's too sad.
Oh, it's too sad.
But I'm in love. I'm in love with you. Oh, oh, oh. You love me.
Oh, you love
and
me.
And then you snub. Every now and then I would watch the Country Music Awards, you know, when no one was looking. And I saw her singing, and I don't know, just something about her.
I'll never see the light.
Never gonna see the light.
I get the blues.
I think the blues and country music are very close. I've always said that if you can get the emotion, the deep down gutsy feeling of R&B, and the very relatable lyrics from country, you've got a monster song.
It's too bad, and it's too sad.
Oh, and it's sad.
'Cause I'm still in love with you. Oh,
oh, oh.
First you love me.
Oh, you love me.
Then you guess I'll never see the light.
Never, 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 never. I get the blues most every single night. Yes, since I fell for you. Oh, you, you, oh, you.
Since I fell for you.
I love country music. I'm religiously in love with it, and I always have been.
But the honky tonks and lonely songs I left behind when I left you.
It's just real close to country music, and I love rhythm and blues. And this is the reason I've always loved B.B. King.
No one man ever enters her mind. She loved to flirt with maybe 8 or 9. She loved to go out and have a ball.
B.B. King, I sort of like raised that boy, you know. He came to Memphis from a little town down in Mississippi called Indianola.
I lived in the Delta, and there was no music stores or anything near us, so we had to order things by mail order. And the first songs I learned about the musical notation was My Darling Clementine, You Are My Sunshine. The governor of Louisiana, Jimmy
right.
Davis.
Jimmy.
So in the Delta, we call country music the white man's blues, and ours was the other blues. And so we both crossed over and sang some of all.
2 days later, Papa passed away. I became a man that day. Every day I had to work the fields, 'cause that's the only way we got our
up and living in a brand new home. Lord knows it took a lot of sweat and tears and my daddy's voice to help us through the years. He said, that's you.
It's American music. That's what we call American music. Something that you can relate to. Something that happens every day in people's lives.
You think because if a white man comes home in the morning and he be living with his wife for 25 years and got 4 children, and he comes home from work in the evening, and when he gets there and opens up that door, there's no furniture in the house, nothing, bare walls. Even the linoleum up off the floor, salt out of the shakers. And just because he's white, you think he ain't got the blues?
And that's what rhythm and blues is, the stories are about, like Patches, and that's what country music is about.
Patches, I'm depending on your son to pull the family through. My son, it's all left up.
Patches, I'm depending on your son. I tried to do my best. It's up to you to do it. Patches, I'm depending on your son to pull the family through. My son, it's all left up to you.
Memphis celebrates the individual, and there has never been a major record company affiliation in Memphis to survive.
Nashville became a music center relatively late, and really as a result of a series of historical accidents. Certainly one of the most important factors was that the Grand Ole Opry was in Nashville.
Speaking of Grand Ole Opry, everybody expects some picking and singing. Well, that's what we're going to do for you here tonight. So we'll start off with a little bit of Hillbilly Fever. Yeah!
So the Opry gradually gathered in the finest talent in country music. And it became natural for people to begin to record here in Nashville if they wanted to work with that talent.
Hey, good looking. What you got cooking? About cooking something up in me.
The really ironic thing is the first Patsy Cline song I ever remember hearing was I Fall to Pieces, because my parents had one of those, you know, great country hits of the stars albums you could probably buy off the television.
And I fall to pieces.
And so we recorded I Fall to Pieces, put it out, and it became a hit. Eventually, it took a long time. It was like several, eight months, because we tried so hard to get a hit. And she said, you know, I never did like that song.
I think it's really dangerous to try to recapture Patsy's moment. We've been dealing with some, that's one of the real challenges of this record. And it's incumbent upon me after leaving the studio not to try to you know, destroy that moment or obscure the essence of what was happening. The reason we have so many musicians playing live is to try to really walk out of here with as close to a finished record as we can.
Each time I see you again,
Aaron Neville, in his own way, I believe, is what Jerry Lee Lewis likes to call a stylist, someone sort of like Al Jolson, Jimmy Rogers, Hank Williams.
How can I be just your friend? You want me to act like we never kissed. You want me to forget, pretend we've never met. And I've tried, and I've tried, but I haven't yet. You walk by.
Stereotype country music is, they think we're all hillbillies. I think we're proving right now that country music is more than just singing through your nose and being unaware about all kinds of other kinds of music.
Rhythm and blues was a black music first and foremost. It was designed, structured, conceived, and geared for black audiences. At the same time, though, you had the phenomenon from the late 40s into the early 50s and prior to the emergence of rock and roll, in which more and more white youngsters began to hear it and were attracted to it. And politically, of course, people who were opposed to it immediately realized that if whites began to listen to the music and begin to view the people who made the music as no different than they are, well then, that was obviously going to lead to them questioning the kinds of laws that kept them apart.
Little Richard is an amazing character. It was a degree of mania that he injected into the music. Forget about R&B, rock and roll. He just definitions really have no bearing.
You know, she's more than a country singer to me, and country music is one of my favorite music. I'm from Georgia, and I've always loved country music. Bill Monroe and Hank Williams, all those people from way, way back. Because it's true. They sings the truth. And when I heard this girl, I said, this girl can sing. She is a rock and roll singer.
Shut up.
Well, look at that. Here she comes. Here comes that girl again. Wanted to date her since I don't know when. But she don't notice me when I pass. She go with all the guys from out of my class. That can't stop me from thinking to myself. Oh, she's good looking, man. She's something else.
Hey, look at there. Across the street. There's a car made just for me. To own that car would be a luxury. But right now I can't afford the gas. A brand new convertible is out of my class. That can't stop me from thinking to myself. That car is fine looking, man. Wow, it's something else.
Hey, look at here. Just wait and see. Something else.
Oh, look at here. What's all this? I never thought I'd do this before. But here I am, I'm knocking on his door. My car's out front, and it's all mine. Just a 41 Ford, not a 59. I got that boy, and I'm thinking to myself, he's sure a fine looking man. Wow, he's something else.
It's something else.
It's something else.
One, two, three.
I've been a fan of his for probably 25, 30 years.
Well, in New Orleans, we say there's God and there's Chet Atkins.
And now with this project, we're recording some together, black music and white music, and it's been coming closer together, really, ever since Elvis.
For me personally, growing up, cutting my musical fandom in the 50s, early rock and roll was essentially, country music, rockabilly, and R&B. So that's what it was. That's what those of us kids in the 50s were listening to.
So in the mid-50s, you have Elvis here in the center, sort of representing the advent of rock and roll. Though rock and roll really had preceded him by a dozen or so years, in the popular mind, he was the avatar of rock and roll.
Elvis's impact on black music was like nothing else, because it really gave black music an injection that it hadn't had before. A white boy doing it now, that makes it good.
And that's what Sam Phillips was looking for. He was looking for a white boy that could sing in a black manner and attract all the kids, and he was right.
Chet Atkins put that rough edge into Elvis's first RCA recordings.
Southern sky, have you ever noticed?
The storyline is a culmination of my early childhood,
it was such a wonderful feeling of being surrounded by everything that was important in life.
And it goes rushing through your soul like the stories told of old, old man.
They'd sit on the porches late at night because there wasn't a lot of electric lights around, and they'd tell these stories. And the wind would blow through the trees, and the moon was out. And then a big gush of wind would come and blow right through your soul, seemed like.
Weeping willow would cry for joy.
Chet Atkins is a major player in the development of Nashville as a recording center. He was the guy who really went into the studio and had a major role in how country records sounded from the late 1950s through the middle 1970s. Rockabilly sprang out of Memphis in the middle 1950s and horrified country because it really pulled fans away from the traditional country artists. Conway was really somebody who came out of the burst of energy of rock and roll and rockabilly, and then landed as a country singer.
Hovering by my suitcase, trying to find a warm place to spend the night. Drops falling, seems I hear your voice calling, it's all right. It's a rainy night in Georgia, a rainy night in Georgia. Lord, I believe it's raining on.
Anytime you hear a Conway Twitty song, you always hear a lot, certainly hear country, but you always hear a little gospel, both black and white and blue.
Neon signs are flashing, taxi cabs and buses passing through the night. A distant moan of a train seemed to play a sad refrain to the night. A rainy night in Georgia. A rainy night in Georgia.
If you play back some of the old material of Sam and Dave, you'll hear a whole heap of country in there. You'll hear, even with Soul Man, you'll hear the opening line. It's country.
I'm coming to you.
If you would take the horns away from the Sam and Dave material, you would hear all country. Because this is where we basically started.
I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man.
Soul music goes with country music. There's just a, if there's a line at all, it's a tiny one.
Raining all over the world.
You know, I kind of like it when it rains like that.
You like that?
Bring back some memories from a long time ago.
It does.
Remember how the rain used to sound?
It just makes you wanna
You know, sometimes you sit back and go, la da la da 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 da.
Yeah, it made me want to, but I can't, Sam.
Oh, you can do it. Try.
But I can tell you this. What? I remember how that rain used to sound on that tin roof back
home. Yeah, do that deep thing. I like to hear you do it.
That's it. That's the one right there. Oh, Brook Benton, where are you, son?
God, if the rain is bad, it's
bad. Hey, Sam, I think I'm getting wet.
All over the world. Woo!
Good job, Sam. Yeah.
Got away!
Stop. Okay.
Something is wrong.
When Something's Wrong with My Baby. That's one of my favorite all-time rhythm and blues soul ballads, written by Isaac Hayes and David Porter.
We chose the Travis Tritt Patti LaBelle song like just the other day, and turns out Patty's got a lot of preparation. Travis wanted to do Sam and Dave's When Something's Wrong with My Baby. Turns out Dave was Patty's cousin, and so she's done a lifetime of preparation for it.
Sam and Dave, Stax Records, back in about what, 1966 or 7? I'm not sure. You remember the year?
I don't remember the year, nor the month, nor the day. I can tell you approximately what happened. It happened a lot the same way every day. We'd all get to the studio about 11 o'clock, and David would be showing Sam and Dave the lyric and how it went with the song, and Andy
and
I would show up.
And singing it to him in front of him and everything.
I never heard Black and White during that whole tenure with Stax. All I heard was music and people putting that stuff together.
And this was all being done in a time in which segregation was still the law of the land, and these people could actually be arrested. They'd leave the studio and they couldn't go out and get a meal together.
And we didn't think much about that. And it was before integration. We were driving through Mississippi and Alabama to get to Muscle Shoals. And we stopped a lot of times at a little Dairy Queen in Mississippi, about halfway, to get food. And the first time we stopped there, they still had a colored window on the side and a white window in the front. My dilemma was whether to get out and go with the black guys through the side window and piss off the rednecks, or go the white window in the front and piss off my pals. So I just stay in the car, give Andrew $5, say, bring me a cheeseburger and shake.
When something is wrong with my baby.
You know, I think of Travis as being a guy with one foot in a southern rock band and one foot in country music.
Just when you try to think that I'm in this little category and you put me in this little box, I'm gonna jump
right
over
out.
Here. I'm over here. I'm not gonna stay there. Because that's, you know, it's not part of what I am. I'm a mixture of every different kind of music that I grew up listening to. I'm a product of my influences.
Thank you.
just don't have a clue, babe. Boy, you don't understand.
Yeah, people say, they say that she's just no good. She's my woman. Oh, and I know I'm her man.
I think that traditionally speaking, in the history of R&B, there's been more crossover than from country, if you see what I mean. I mean, one of the standard things to do in the 60s or early 70s with an R&B artist was to cut a country song. This, I guess, was started by Ray Charles.
Hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How about cooking something up with me?
What we're really looking for are songs that are incredible songs that could be done by either a country artist or an R&B artist, but that are larger than either, you know, faction, if you will.
This is Al Green.
How you doing? Oh, doing fine. It's been so long now, and it seems like it was only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? Hey, 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 yeah.
All right, now.
Go. Ain't it funny how time slips away?
I still did it wrong.
Ain't it? Ain't it?
Yeah, see, Lyle is singing my note.
Uh-oh.
He don't seem to want to sing his note.
Well, show him my note again.
Ain't it funny?
Ain't it funny?
Yeah.
Funny how time slips away.
Yeah.
It should be good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the song itself.
You know,
is that country and western song?
Gee, ain't it funny how time just slips away.
I got to sing
Funny How Time Slips Away for Willie Nelson's birthday party a while back. And the idea of being able to sort of marry these two versions of the song was really exciting to me.
Ain't it funny how time slips away? Somewhere around. I don't know when, never know when I'll be back in time. Remember what I told you. In time, you're gonna pay. Ain't it funny how time slips away?
The soul era, I think, was the final fruition for what I consider to be the greatest form of vocal music, which is gospel, being adapted wholly into the popular sector.
Now you're
a
man. Are you still doing church on Sunday?
Oh, yeah, occasionally.
Every Sunday, I mean.
You gotta come. Bring your wife and you come and enjoy it, man.
All great music does reflect the era in which it comes, but I think the truly timeless music, I think, will always have something to say.
Change, change, change.
Change, change, change.
Sure, he was going to be a producer today, but now that he's on the phone.
This isn't a phone.
Are you listening to the track?
Yes.
You can hear the track. Yes. Man, that's great. This...
Clint Black is a very interesting performer because he's a real honky tonk country singer, and I think you can draw a line from Clint to George Strait to George Jones to Lefty Frizzell to Hank Williams.
I've got goosebumps, you know, just thinking about that, you know, the significance of us doing this song.
Yeah,
together,
you know,
where that comes
times
from.
Times, they are changing, I think.
You got me where you want me.
We're not going to go all the way through. This is just to set Gladys' level and check the tempo.
Oh, no, this project gave me a great excuse to work with two people I've been dying to work with. You know, Gladys Knight, obviously. I come from Detroit. You know, this is 30 years of wanting to work with Gladys Knight.
So glad we've got the real thing.
I personally find it much harder to cover a song like Ain't Nothing Like the Real Thing, which is a perfect record.
Well, all we had was the hook, though, and then it was like strange because when he came up with the verse, I said, it's kind of like poetry, you know, it's kind of, you know, your picture on the wall, I can't see, you'll come to me. It's kind of poetic. Is this down enough?
Well, Ashford and Simpson Ain't Nothing Like the Real Thing, and Motown in general really represents kind of the other complete end of the spectrum from Stax and Southern Soul.
Ain't nothing like the real thing.
Ooh. Yeah.
Vince Gladys, the intro be exactly the same as the record. It's like two bars and then in. One bar drums and then da-da-da-da-da.
Well, Vince is the guy who is, he is returning the tenor singer to the heartthrob status within country music.
You would think that R&B music and the perception of country music being a redneck music and so on and so forth, that they would be
like that,
at opposite ends of the spectrum, but I see them like...
Just like that.
Right there.
I really do.
He's leaving. Leaving.
A lot of people don't know that the original title to Midnight Train to Georgia.
Midnight Plane
Midnight
to Houston.
Plane to Houston. Yeah.
I said, I do not know too much about Houston, and I sure don't like to fly.
Ain't nothing like the real thing, baby. Ain't nothing like the real thing.
by the end, it became clear that there was this fabric of shared human experience. I suppose it's the humanistic message of the record, that, that beneath skin color, what you're dealing with is human emotion.
I've never heard a story told like country people tell a story musically. It is so raw and so basic, everybody can understand it.
So glad we got the real thing, baby. So glad we got the real thing.
I love the emotion and the soul, you know, and that comes in country music and R&B music both.
I think country music is great. It's doing great right now. But I think we got too much up stuff. We got too much happy stuff. I think the feeling needs to really get back, like rhythm and blues, and needs to get back to basics.
Blues has no color. Blues is that feeling that distorts your mind or rip your insides out.
Well, hello there. Mine's been a long time. How am I doing? Well, I guess I'm doing fine. It's been so long now, and it seems like it was only yesterday.
Ain't it funny how time slips away?
Hey.
How's your new love? I hope he's doing fine. I heard you told him you're gonna love till the